What would you think of when we talk about Bristol? It's the largest city in southwest England and one of the most vibrant cities in the UK. Bristol is famous for its maritime history, the people's independent spirit, the street art and graffitis, the hometown of the renowned graffiti artist Banksy, and hot air balloon fiesta. This is one of the coolest cities in the UK. My journey started from the harbour side, where both Bristol's glory and dark history began. Step on Brunel's SS Great Britain, the world's first great ocean liner, launched in 1843, 69 years earlier than Titanic. She was the most advanced ship at the time and was used in the transatlantic service between Bristol and New York City. She shortened the journey from several months to 2 weeks. The ship is now a museum, and it vividly presents what it was like living on the ship over 150 years ago. SS Great Britain was designed by Isambard Kingdom Brunel, who is considered one of the most ingenious engineers in the Industrial Revolution and in English history. He also designed another Bristol landmark, the Clifton Suspension Bridge, as well as the Great Western Railway, the Thames Tunnel in London, and many other bridges. Stepping out of the ship, now it's time to enjoy the beautiful harbourside and chill. Watch the ferries come and go, listen to the seagulls sing, feel the sunlight touch your skin. If you're with kids, check out the amusement park and Bristol Aquarium. If you are into the culture and history, the Amshed Museum is an excellent place to visit. The Amshed Museum is sitting on the harbour side and is all about the history, the life and the people in Bristol. Here, you can learn so much about how and why Bristol has transformed over time. The city's trading history, the things Bristolians created from art to technology, how do people celebrate festivals? How do people challenge for their rights over time? You can also see the statue of the slave trader Edward Colston, which was toppled and dumped into the water by the Bristolian protesters in the Black Lives Matter movement in 2020. The statue is still covered in graffiti and surrounded by placards used by the protesters. It's yet to be decided what to do with the statue in the future. Getting hungry? The cargo right behind Amshed Museum is the perfect one-stop shop for independent eateries. Asian, Italian, Spanish, vegetarian, even Michelin star restaurant. Whatever you fancy, you got it. I went for this highly rated tapas place called Gambas. Super fresh seafood, perfectly flavored, beautiful cocktail, and gorgeous harbor view. Now let's head to Stoneycroft and explore the street art and graffitis. Bristol is the hometown of Banksy, probably the most well-known graffiti artist. Graffitis started in Bristol long before Banksy, but Banksy truly brought graffitis to the public attention when Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt went to his exhibition and spent £1 million on his artwork. What made Banksy special is that there's always a meaning in his graffitis. Some are about politics, some are about the world and humanity, some mock the phenomena in the society. There's so much to say about the ingenious graffiti pieces, and I feel like I should make a separate video on them. Oh, I forgot to mention, Banksy is not his real name. Up to today, we still don't know his true identity, and the mystery is very important to Banksy. After all, it doesn't matter who he is. What matters is that he used his creativity and art to speak up for the things we feel but don't know how to express. What matters is he made art available to everybody, not just the super rich. After hours of walking and exploring of the graffitis, time to get some coffee. And that's the perfect timing to head to Bristol Old City. The exchange was previously a corn and general trade exchange built in the 1740s. Now it houses the St. Nicholas Market. Walk along Corn Street and Broad Street. You can find interesting coffee shops and independent stores. Also check out Christmas Steps, pretty narrow street with lovely little stores. Let's go a bit further away from the city center to Clifton and check out another must-do in Bristol, the Bristol Suspension Bridge, a spectacular work Brunel designed, although he never lived to see his creation finished. Brunel designed the bridge at the age of 24, but financial difficulties led to long delays. After Brunel died, his colleagues started to raise new funds to complete it as a memorial for Brunel. The Clifton Suspension Bridge's spectacular setting on the cliffs of the Avon Gorge has made it the defining symbol of Bristol. I spent 2 days in Bristol and already fell for this city. I hope you enjoyed the video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will see you next time.